What's up, babes? Today we're gonna be doing a brow tutorial. They look like twins, but they are not. They are sisters because I did do them in two different ways. One a little bit more natural and bushy, the other one extremely easy and quick for your everyday morning. A lot of you guys have asked me for this, so I'm happy I'm finally getting it out. So we ain't gonna talk too much. Make sure you hit subscribe, hit that notification bell, and let's hop into it. Okay, so for this tutorial, I am gonna be using my minted Take a Brow pencil. Obviously, you can use any brow pencil that you like, but for me, this is my favorite one to use right now. Usually, I do like a very fine tipped liner. Sometimes I go in with a brow pomade, most times I don't. I do like to be able to control my stroke, so this, or Precisely My Brow by Benefit, or the Fenty Beauty Brow, or even the Anastasia, those are all my favorite ones, but right now, this one takes the cake. So the first brow I'm gonna show you guys is more of a structured, very artistic way of doing your brows. This is not the way I do it most of the time, but I figured I'll put two tutorials in one. One super, super easy one for anybody, and one that, you know, was more brush strokes. So I feel like if you want to be the person that does brush strokes, you really just need to follow the natural way that your brows go. So I'm gonna just start at the front and go upwards with the brush strokes. Y'all see that already? It's very feathered right here naturally, so I do wanna keep that going in the front. So I'll go upwards and then start to go out. So this makes it thicker, and you're also kinda creating a shape. You'll start right where your hair is growing out, because I am just following my own shape and going upwards like that. But we're making it very natural looking hair like strokes. Even the ones at the top, I'm kind of pulling them over like that so that it looks as natural as possible. Already you're seeing the difference between this one and this one. This one is extremely thicker. So obviously I'm a person that takes off my brows. I have very rectangular brows. Not really a fan of that. So I do kind of shave off the bottom part of it, and I extend with a pencil. So I'm going to take the pencil and just make hair-like strokes going downward. Now these strokes are not super sharp, which I'm cool with, but if you're looking from a distance, it still looks very natural. So we pretty much have a good shape of a brow. It's very natural and kind of bushy looking. For this one, I am gonna go ahead in with my concealer. This is a Stay Naked Correcting Concealer from Urban Decay. And I'm just gonna go ahead and put a few dots underneath, and I'm gonna take my brush. This brush is what I recommend for brows. A lot of people use angled brushes. I don't recommend this. The reason I recommend a brush like this is because it's like a flat paddle brush. It's because it has a rounded edge that is extremely sharp, and you turn to the side, it is super sharp, so don't get one that's super, super thick, and it can help with blending as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and take my paddle brush and grab that concealer on my way over as I go and start to sculpt out the brow. And then I go downwards just to start to blend it, or start the blend into the skin. So one thing about this is you can low-key create more space where your brow is by using concealer. Also with this, if you put this in places where you don't actually have hair and then you sculpt it out underneath that, magically you have hair there, so it's all good. So for the top of the brow, I recommend using your foundation shade. I'm gonna use my NARS Macau, and I'm gonna go ahead and line the top sharp just like I did the bottom. And see, using this flat brush, look how you can just easily start to blend that into the skin. Very, very easy. That's why I recommend this brush. I'm gonna take the other side and just brush my hairs upwards just to keep it with that very bushy feel. And that brow is done. Now, here's the thing. I feel like you ain't even gotta do all that with the brush strokes and all that to make it look super like natural. I'm gonna show you what I do. I've talked about this in a few of my videos, but we're gonna go ahead and do it really detailed today. But it's not really that much detail, so. For this side, it's gonna be extremely, extremely easy. So I feel like this is perfect for beginners or someone who doesn't really know how to be super artistic with it. So what I'm gonna do is draw a line at the bottom where I want my brow to be. I'm also gonna make a line at the top where I want my brow to be. Then on the end, I'm going to just come downwards how I want my arch. So I'm essentially just creating this myself. If you already have hair there, then you essentially just follow your own shape or where you want it to be. And then on the front, I'm lightly gonna draw inside the brow to just fill it in. I'm gonna take the spoolie part of the pencil and at the front, because obviously we see this is very, very boxy and that is not what we want. I'm going to just start going this direction to make this an ombre. Now, yes, it's disappearing there. I take my finger and I just rub that in. And suddenly we have an ombre brow. Easy, right? And the thing I like about doing that is you can easily create a shape and create like an extension of your brow right there to where it is ombre. From there, I'm gonna continue to take the spoolie just to blend my hairs into the pencil that's there. And we're ready to sculpt. I'm gonna go back in with my concealer, same thing I did before, a few dots, and then take the paddle brush and sculpt it out. And I feel like this is more of an everyday brow for like the everyday girl, not necessarily if you're doing a full face of makeup. Of course, I'm taking my foundation to sculpt out the top. I usually take my beauty blender if I'm not about to do like an eye look or anything. If this is just like for the office in the morning, I'm not about to do anything else. I take my beauty blender and just blend the concealer and the foundation into my skin. That way we don't see any lines of demarcation. It's a seamless blend of color. I'm gonna go back in with my pencil and just fill in where I'm missing, where I want it to be darker. And this is obviously not brush like strokes. I'm just kind of drawing it in there. I feel like this side is a very easy brow to accomplish if you're a beginner, if you're new, if you just want a very sculpted brow on your face and you can't do all the extra, then that's perfect. This one a little bit more natural looking. You can see more of our brush strokes, you know, and it's cool. To bring more definition into your brows, you can also go in with a brow gel, and this one is from a Benefit. And I'm just gonna softly follow my hair strokes and put that gel in there. Some gels are clear. This one is not clear. It is in the number 6, but it just adds dimension and makes your brows look a little more natural. All right, babes, I hope you enjoyed this brow tutorial. It has been long overdue, so I'm happy I did an updated one for you guys. Please make sure you give me a big thumbs up, comment below and let me know what you thought, if you're gonna use any of these tips or if you already do. Also, make sure you hit subscribe below and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.